Hello friends, in this video tutorial we discuss about the compile time initialization of the array. Let's see with practical. And simply I click on the file and then new and click on the project. Select the console application from the template and click on the go, and from here I select the C language and then click on the next. Here I need to provide my project title, and simply I provide my project title as a array, and array demo 1, then click on the next and then finish. My project displayed under the workspace, and simply I explore the sources and then click on the main.c. look here, this code is automatically generated by the code block, and simply I delete this message and write here compile time. Compile time initialization of one dimensional array. And initialization. Okay. In the next line, I'm simply declaring a variable I and int. Here, giving here the size as a 5 equal and then semicolon, giving here the value 20 comma 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma 40 and 50. Okay, and in the next line I am using the for loop and simply initialize the value of I as a 0, giving here the condition I less than 5 and then I plus plus, and then opening and closing brace. I am using here the printf function within the body of the loop, and simply write here percentage d comma arr, and then give passing here within the subscript of the array as I and terminated with semicolon, and simply I want to provide the space, so I write here printf and provide the space terminated with semicolon and save it. Look here, this is the first printf function. Simply print the message compile time initialization of one dimensional array onto the screen. In the next line I am declaring a variable I, and here I am declaring the one dimensional array. First, I need here to write the data type of my array. I simply giving here my data type of the array is int, and arr is the name of the array. And within the subscript, I am giving here the size of my array. And the size of my array is 5, means this array stores the 5 element. And I write here equal, and then within the curly bracket I am simply giving here the values 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50 values to this array, means this value, this element values are stored into the array. And 10 value simply store at the 0 index position, 20 value store at the 1 index position, 30 value store at the 2nd index position, 40 value store at the 3rd index position, and 50 value store at the 4th index position of the array. And in the next line I am using the for loop to print these elements onto the screen. And simply I write here initialize the value of I as a 0, and giving here the condition I less than 5, because the index of the array start from the 0 and going to 4, because the size of array is 5, so always the index position less than their size, and here incremented by 1. The first, the value of I initialized as a 0, and control check the condition, come into the body part, and with the help of this printf function I simply write here arr, and within the subscript I am passing the variable I, and the first time the value of I is 0, so the array at the 0 index position contain the value as a 10, so this 10 value print onto the screen And with the help of this printf function, simply provide the space. Control again, come here and increment the value of I as a 1. And after increment, the value of I is 1. Check the condition. Condition is true. So control again, come here. And with the help of this statement, the value of 1 index position print onto the screen, and the 1 index position, the value is 20. So 20 value print onto the screen. Control come in, come to next line and simply provide the space with the help of this printf function. Control again come here and increment the value of I as a 1. After increment, the value of I is 2. Control check the condition. Condition is true. And control come here and simply print the value of second index position. And the second index position, the value is 30. So 30 value print onto the screen. Control simply come to the next line and provide the space. Come here and increment the value of I as a 1. After increment, the value of I is simply 3. And check the condition. Condition is true. Control again come here and print the value of third index position. And the third index position, the value stored as a 40 onto the screen, so into the array. So 40 value print onto the screen. Control simply come to the next line and with the help of this printf function provide the space. Control again come here and increment the value of I is a 1. After increment, the value of I is 4. So check the condition. Condition is true. Control again come here and simply print the print the element that is stored at the fourth index position. So the fourth index position, the value is 50. So 50 value print onto the screen and then take space with the help of this printf function. Control again come here, increment the value of I as a 1. After increment, the value of I is 5. So check the condition. Condition is false. So loop is terminated here. And the array element 10, 20, 30, 40 value print onto the screen with the help of this for loop. And I first save it and run it. Look here, this is the element of the array 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Okay. Thank you friends. This is the compile time initialization of one dimensional array or single dimensional array. Thank you friends. Thanks for watching my video. Please comment on my video and like my video. Thanks a lot.